Find this in my stash later. Mirror light. Last part of the Sundom before the Forbidden West. And Karja Horn. And that means the Lipsy Stories.
Oh! I could use your insights later.
Alright, I should find whoever's in charge here. But first, I could resupply at my stash. It'd be worth taking a look around, too.
Hey, heard you took out the bristlebacks. Nicely done!
Savior, tell me, are you seeking passage into no man's land by any chance?
Maybe. Why do you ask?
Ah, well, to hammer it plain, there's treasure out west. Unclaimed scrap and ancient metal. And I've got a sturdy band of salvagers that knows the lay of the land.
You're not afraid of the Tanakh?
Terrified. But I carry out most of my business in no man's land. Neutral territory and all that. Barrenlight is our port of entry. When its doors aren't closed for an embassy. I was hoping your arrival meant they might be opening soon. I've got a business to run, after all.
I want that embassy to happen as much as you do. Believe me, I'm working on it.
Good to know. And keep us in mind. If you do manage to open the way, our main camp will be just past Barrenlight. We'll buy any scrap you've got on you. And if you're looking for machine parts, we've got the best in the West. Guaranteed.
All right. Maybe later then.
If you could get those blasted gates open.
I guess I'm not the only one who wants to get those gates open.
Wants to play some strike? Anyone?
Sorry if I gave you the wrong impression, Bob.
like new coal for the fire. You'll burn fierce.
Come on then. No one's up for a game of strike?
The man built this town, you know.
By slaving the rest of it. You know who gets all the shards?
I've got boards ready to go.
The savior of Meridian. Will help you.
Stay true to the Sun King.
Another day, perhaps.
There's Erend.
You're in a sour mood.
Looks like he's had a few.
A broken ribs will do that to you.
Gentlemen.
That's our cue.
You taking the edge off?
I mean, I'd ask you to join, but who'd be left to save the world, right? All right, now let me guess. You're in a rush, right? So, whatever you need. Ask away.
How have things been since
Your silent departure? Yeah, not bad. Vanguard's going strong. Helped Avad pick up the pieces after the battle with the Eclipse. I took a month to bury Ursa in the claim. But when I got back, I got the assignment to babysit Voidis on his way to the embassy. I thought that'd be a cakewalk, so of course things went sideways.
You got blindsided. Wasn't your fault.
A couple more of these, maybe I'll believe you.
I was, wondering if you were able to lay Ursa to rest, like you wanted.
Yeah, we did. Just seen the crowd that showed up to pay their respects. Half of them owed her a favor, and the other half owed her their lives. In the end, everybody drank. You know, that is the rowdiest funeral since ever.
Feels like she would have liked that.
Yeah, damn straight. Damn straight. She would have put them all under the table.
What do you know about the embassy?
I know not much. Only that Avad really wants it to happen. He said I'm making peace with these Tanakh. But from what I hear, they're not too big on the whole diplomacy thing. They do most of their talking with blades and arrows. So if you're heading their way, be prepared. Things might get ugly real fast.
I'll keep that in mind. What do you know about this place?
Well, nothing good. It's where the Karja dragged all the captives they took from the Forbidden West during the Red Raids. Lucky ones became slave labor. The rest were hauled off to the Sun Ring in Meridian.
For sacrifice.
You got it. Tanakh made sure to wreck the place before they chased the Karja out of the West. I can't say I blame them. And now Avad's paying the Osram to rebuild it. And no matter how much new stone they put up, it'll still be stained in blood.
I better get going.
Oh, yeah, don't let me stop you. Just, are you sure about this? Yeah, I'm saving the world. That sounds like a lot for just one
errand.
Yeah, all right. Can't blame me for trying. I guess what I'm really trying to say is, if you ever do need me,
I know where to find you. Hopefully sober next time.
Yeah, don't count on it. Be careful out there, Aloy.
Savior, please, I need to speak to
you. I know you see me.
Savior, you're my last hope.
Conover, she's Meridian's savior, not yours.
It's just Aloy. What do you want?
Please, no one will listen. But the Eclipse, they're here in the Daunt.
Really, Conover? Aloy's the one that defeated them. You're bothering her with this hogwash now?
Some of them must have fled west after the battle at the Alight. I saw one of our sentries, Lorovic, sneaking off to meet with one. I tried to eavesdrop, but they spotted me. And then Lorovic tried to kill me. I fought back. It was him or me.
Unfortunately, there's no hard evidence that connects Lorovic to the Eclipse. And since Conover doesn't deny killing his fellow soldier, Nozar sentenced him to death.
What makes you so sure Lorovic was working with the Eclipse?
Well, I was too far to hear everything. But I heard them both say the word Eclipse.
It's not the most outlandish claim I've heard, but it's up there.
Crying Eclipse is a convenient way to dodge a death sentence.
If I have to die, so be it. But if we ignore this threat, others are going to die too.
Tell me exactly what happened.
Weeks ago, during a shift change, some trespassers slipped through the gate. By the time anyone noticed, they were halfway out the canyon. Nozar didn't see the need to give chase. Let the Tanakhs take care of them, he said.
Nozar's not one to be sidetracked. He tightened up the patrol schedules, reprimanded the sentries, and everyone moved on.
But I couldn't stop thinking about it. None of us are careless out here, meaning someone left it open on purpose. And Lorovic, well, he's always grumbling about officers. But on this, he was too quiet. And after the incident, he started acting different, jumpy. So when I spotted him sneaking out of the barracks after hours, I followed. I found him arguing with a stranger. And when Lorovic mentioned the Eclipse, I tried getting closer, but they hurt me. The stranger took off, and Lorovic lunged at me with his knife. Instincts took over. Sentries heard the scuffle and found me standing over his body.
Why don't you believe him?
We combed the woods, searched Larovik's bunk, searched it again, didn't find anything. Look, Conover's a good man. I don't believe he murdered Larovik in cold blood. But Nozar only listens to facts. And that fact is, Conover killed his fellow sentry. He doesn't deny it, right?
No, but more Eclipse are out there.
And considering there's no evidence backing up this Eclipse story, well, we can't question a dead man. Nozar's on edge with the upcoming embassy and doesn't want distractions. But hey, if you find a bunch of Eclipse soldiers hatching an evil plot in the woods, please do let us know.
The meeting you witnessed, did you hear anything else about their plans?
No. But the clearing where they met is just east of here, across the river.
A dozen soldiers have already searched it, Conover. There's nothing there.
I can see things others can't. If the Eclipse are in the Daunt, I'll find them.
Thank you, Aloy. Sun bless your search.
Don't get your hopes up, soldier.
Thank you.
find me.
Through the clearing where Conover says he saw the eclipse. Bloodstains. It's as good a place to start as any. Pretty sure this is where Conover killed that guard. Maybe my focus can tell me if there really was a third person here. I see plenty of tracks from the Karja search party. Not helpful. Broken branches. Was someone up here? Faint tracks. Leading away from barren light. I should be able to follow them with my focus. Let's see where this leads. Maybe Conover wasn't lying after all. Oh, my pack's full. I can get it for my stash later. The trail. There's too many machines walking around. Maybe I can pick up the tracks once I'm past them. Should be easy to follow the trail up ahead now. Thank you. machine must have slashed it. Should be easy to follow the blood trail with my focus. Looks like they're headed for that bridge. Someone set up a lookout down here. Bandages. Looks like the runner tried to treat their wounds before they went on. I should be able to follow their tracks. Where did you go off to? Stash this away for later. The trail ends here. Must have climbed up to that cave. With that injury, I'll bet he's on his last legs. This looks like a good place for someone to hide.
Yes! What are we supposed to do now?
We stay on track and make our way out west.
If we give up now, the user will leave. We have to find Ezra.
In his shadow, we will find strength.
We don't know Larvik's dead.
He hasn't shown at the rendezvous point. So either that fool guard killed him, or he's lost his nerve.
We'll just have to blast our way through the gates.
And then what? Rayad was our only link to Vezra, and now he's dead too.
We'll track Vezra if we have to. But first we have to get past Baron Light. Next change of guard, we go in fast and loud.
Conover was right. I have to stop them before they hurt anyone else.
The shadow will rise again. A new dawn is coming.
There! You see that?
You sure this time?
No more sneaking around.
Hang in there!
For the crew, Karja!
That takes care of that. But I'm sure there's more of them outside. I better be careful.
over there! Firing!
This Rayad was their only link to them. He might have a focus. He could tell me where they are. I'm guessing that's Rayad. I was right. Rayad has a focus.
Loyal Eclipse. If you're seeing this, it means you've left the Sundom in search of something to follow. Your journey is almost over. Follow the sun beyond the gates of barren light. And bask in the gloom of future conquest. A new empire awaits.
I'll have to pay this Vezra a visit and crush his new Eclipse empire before it begins. There's coordinates here, out past Barren Light. Rayad's mask should be enough to prove Conover's innocence. I better take it back to Barren Light. When we fought the Eclipse back in Meridian, I thought that'd be the end of it. Guess I was wrong. Where's Erend? It looks like he's had a few.
Look alive, soldier. She's back.
Aloy! Did you find anything?
Eclipse fugitives were camped out on the other side of the forest. And they were getting ready to fight their way through Barrenlight. You just helped save a lot of lives.
Aloy, you know I believe you. But Nozar, he might not be convinced by your words alone.
If he needs proof, show him that. And tell him the man he's got locked up risked his life to expose and eliminate an Eclipse spy.
Huh. I guess you are his savior. Congratulations, soldier. You're a free man. I'll have you out of there before sunfall. I'll make sure this gets to Nozar.
That's it, then. The end of the Eclipse.
Almost. The trespassers you mentioned, the ones who got through Barrenlight weeks ago, their leader's dangerous. And he's out there, in the Forbidden West, building up an army.
Sun and Shadow, you're going out there to stop him, aren't you?
I'm gonna try.
I want to help. I can fight.
I know you can. But you've been through a lot. Once you're out of that cell, you should enjoy your freedom. You've earned it.
Take them out, Savior.
No one wants to play some strike? I've got board. It's ready to go if I...
Lighten up, Paiv. You've got a thick wall of stone between you and the Tanakh out there.
Yes, sir.
Why the long face, Mavas? Wish you... We're heading out there?
No, sir.
Are you in charge around here?
Ah, apologies, no. That would be Commander Nozar. I'm Lawan, his second in command. So, what brings Aloy of the Nora to Baron Light?
I'm here for the embassy. I need it to happen so I can head west. And maybe now that Studius Wadis is here, we can finally get things underway.
Yes, the Sun Priest. Walked in practically kicking and screaming behind his escort. Really seems to like his scrolls. But the embassy remains delayed. Commander Nozar has signaled our readiness, but the Tanakh marshals have yet to sound their horn.
All right. Fine. Let me through the gates, then. I have my own business with them.
I'm sure you do, but I'm afraid I can't. Commander's orders. Normally, the gates are open for any who dare to venture out. Asaram salvagers, a few especially brazen Karja, but no one's allowed in or out before an embassy. They'll reopen, once the Tanakh have left.
So what happens at these embassies, exactly?
Mostly trade and negotiation. The Karja offer tribute of food, spices, and gear. In exchange, the Tanakh return personal effects taken from Karja soldiers that fell during the Red Raids. This particular embassy, however, is a special case.
Because the Tanakh, they're handing over some sort of prisoner, right? A soldier named Fashav?
Ah, so you've heard. The exchange has got everyone on edge. You never know if an embassy's going to go well until it's practically over.
You said something about Tanakh marshals. Who are they?
They're the tribe's elite warriors. Before every embassy, they arrive with a contingent of soldiers from each of their three clans. Then, during the proceedings, they negotiate on behalf of their leader. And by negotiate, I mean, stare down our Sun Priest until they concede. Paiv over here came face to face with them for the first time at the last embassy. Came back drenched in his own sweat.
It was hot that day, sir.
It was indeed.
Where is this Commander Nozar, then? If he's the one keeping the gates shut, I'll convince him to open them for me.
I'll take you to him. But I have to warn you, the commander isn't one to break protocol, especially when he's already high-strung.
We'll see about that.
This way.
There's a lot of activity going on around here.
The Tanakh tore down this place during the Red Raids.
Two years of labor,
and we still have a long way to go. The work stoppage and chain scrape nearly halted our rebuilding efforts. But I hear a certain Nora got them back to work.
I was just helping out.
Yes, well, I'm sure Alvin was thrilled. Stand aside, soldier.
Sir?
Oi, slag.
How are we to hold an embassy with a tribe that can't even govern their own people?
What more can you expect from barbarians? Ah. Aloy, was it?
Yes. The one who cleared the valley for you? That Aloy.
We appreciate your service. At least we are ready for the embassy to begin.
Didn't you just give the signal?
Both sides must signal readiness. Until the Tanakh sound their horn, we wait.
Yea, for as the first shall be kept.
Shut up. Why the delay?
The Tanakh are a tribe composed of three clans. How many banners do you see?
You're just gonna wait? Go find out what's wrong.
Oh, this isn't some forgotten corner of the East where you come from, Nora. It's the Forbidden West. If you don't like it, run back to Meridian. File a complaint.
The Meridian I saved, you mean?
That's right. Nobody walks through the gate until the third clan arrives and the Tanakh horn has sounded. Not even the savior of Meridian.
Well, thanks, but I've waited long enough. It's time to go.
Absolutely not. This embassy depends on diligent adherence to... You shall not!
Keep telling yourself that.
Someone approaching! On a machine!
Open the gates, please.
Do not let her through that gate! That is a direct order!
Sorry, can't do it.
Sir, it's the savior!
I don't care if it's a devil between herself. The gate needs sealed until that horn grows.
I'm asking nicely.
I don't know what to do.
Hey, Varl.
Hi, Aaron.
What's that? I ain't all the usual. Aloy wants something. People
Open
try to stand in her way. It's not gonna work.
Gates.
That's it. Arrest her.
I'd like to see you try.
Supporting fire?
Yeah, I'm locked and loaded. Hey, Nozar! You stupid bastard. You think you got the authority to keep that door shut in the savior of Meridian's face? What do you think Sun King Avad is gonna do when he hears what you did? Promote you, huh? Let her through, boys. Saving the world.
Forget something back in Meridian?
Look, Varl.
It doesn't matter. Made it just in time. The tribe that Murad told us about, the Tanakh, we need their permission to go west?
Yeah, well, I figured it'd be nice if they weren't trying to kill me the whole time.
But this embassy hasn't started yet. We're just gonna barge in?